Even if you're not sure what the shortcut is supposed to be, even if you're not sure what the graph is supposed to look like, you can always do what to graph this equation? It's what we did yesterday, like the whole time. What is it that we did to graph those equations?
That's we made a table.
We made a table, right? What was that table of? Like, here's a table. What was on this side?
X.
And this side?
Y.
X and Y. Okay. Now, yesterday, I gave you all the X's, I said. Here's the X, here's an X, here's an X, here's an X. I gave you seven X's to plug into that equation. But when you went home and you did your homework, you didn't have me telling you what X's to use. So which X's are you supposed to use?
One.
Any one.
Any X. Right? Any X will give you a Y. And once you have an X and a Y, what are you able to do?
Graph it.
Graph it as a point. Once you have an X and a Y, you can graph it as a point with the X and the Y corresponding to this X and Y. So it's up to you. Choose any X you want. Now, there are X's that are easier than other X's. So what's an X we could throw into this equation? Great.
One.
We could do one. And what is 1/4 times one?
1/4.
It is 1/4. Anything times one is just itself. What's another thing we can plug in there for X?
3.
We can plug in 3. What's 3 times 1/4? Okay, we're having trouble multiplying 3 times 1/4.
7.
1/4 times 3. 1/4 times 3 over 1. Multiply straight across. 1 times 3. 4 times 3. 1. 3/4. It's another number we can plug in for X.
5.
2.
5. 2. These are all correct, but I want some
zero
convenience now. 0. I like 0. Because what is 0 times 1/4?
0.
So that was.
Zero.
If I were to give awards for easiest X value to plug in, I would give the blue ribbon.
Stop.
Okay? The blue ribbon or the green ribbon. I would give it to 0. Because it just doesn't get any easier than plugging in 0. Now, what's another number that's still pretty darn easy? Not as easy as 0, but pretty easy to multiply by 1/4.
1 and then 1/4.
We already did one, so I want a different one.
Negative one.
Negative one times 1/4 is going to be negative 1/4. That wasn't too hard.
Negative 2.
No.
Look at the particular.
2.
2. That's not the one I have in mind, Olivia.
1/4.
1/4. Well, that's not
negative
the one
fourth.
I have in mind. That's not the
point
one
two.
I have in mind.
0.01.
4. Or 4/1.
Right.
Yeah. 4/1.
Let me show you why. I was waiting for that one to come up because if I do the work and I do 1/4 times 4, which I can write as 4 over 1.
4.
It's 1. It's 4 over 4. It's 1.
Oh, I see.
Here's the thing that I like about that. I plug in a whole number and I get out a whole number. Okay, whole number goes in, whole number comes out. Look at these other ones. You put in a whole number, you get out a fraction. Put in a whole number, get out a fraction. Put in a whole number, get out a fraction. Okay. And especially when you're graphing fractions is a little bit of a task. Okay. But whole numbers, they're much easier to graph. They're much easier to work with. Alright. So I'm going to choose to graph this guy here and this one here. I'll even put a little marker and all that. So 0, 0. And if I plug in 4 for X, I'll get 1 for Y. Okay.
Oh.
It sounds so nice in here. Extra credit. Let's do one more. One more point where I plug in a whole number and I get out a whole number. How many do you got one?
4.
You did 4 already.
Oh, 1.
One we did already, we did not get a whole number, we got 1/4.
0.
6. 0 we already did. 6 will give us 1/4 times 6 over 1. That'll be 6 over 4. That'll be 3 over 2. Still a fraction.
8.
Let's look at 8. 8. 1/4 times 8 over 1 equals 8 over 4.
Two.
Two. So if I plug in 8 for x, you get 2 for y. Just plotted 3 points so far. Now, how many points can I find?
Infinite.
An infinite number of points. I can just keep on going. Like, what would be the next number you would plug in for x now that you start to maybe see this pattern? 16,
no.
I might, even before 16, I might do
14.
And 14.
10.
24.
12.
44.
Yeah. Hunter, this is not helpful.
12.
12 would be good. Right? Because 12 is? It's 4 times 3. It's got a factor of 4 in it, and that will be divided by 4. What's another number that would be pretty easy to plug in for x? I heard 16, right?
Yeah.
What happens when we plug in 16? What's 1/4 times 16?
4.
It's 4.
16 fourths.
16 fourths?
Yeah.
Which would be?
4.
4, yeah. What about, what other number can we plug in? Negative 4. You can go to the negatives. Negative 4 will give us negative 1. That's your question.
Can you do like fractions?
You can. Absolutely, you can. But if you did, then you kind of defeated the purpose of looking for easier things to plug in for x. But you can plug in fractions. There are an infinite number of points. All these points will account for all of the possible x's that you can plug in. So, again, we could do negative 4. I'll just do it here, negative 4. What's negative 4 times 1/4?
Negative 1.
So we've got negative 4 over 4, negative 1. So negative 4, negative 1. And there are an infinite number of points. We talked about that. In fact, we found some other ones that are not, you know, the convenient ones, but they're still true, right? 1 gives me 1/4, right? This is 1, so 1/4 would be right about there. Can we stop talking?
Yeah.
Okay. We're plugging in 3. We got 3/4. That's right about there. Okay. We plugged in negative 1. We got negative 1/4. 6 gave us 3/2, so we go over to 5/6. That gave us 3/2 right about there. Even with these points that I'm graphing at fractions, they all seem to be following the same pattern.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right? And all these points, if I were to keep plotting them over, like more and more points, what shape does it look like they would make together?
A line.
A straight line, not a curve. Yeah. We looked at a curve that another kind of function could have, right? Yesterday. Parabola is the specific name of that one. But this particular function happens to have all of its points in a straight line. And if I had graphed this very, very well, those 2 points would be right on. But graph it more precisely, then yes, all of these points will make a straight line. Any questions about that? So in this function, what kind of x values did we like to plug in? Ones that what's that? That made a whole number. Okay, so what kind of number would I have to plug in for x? That when I multiply by 1/4, I get a whole number as my answer.
4, 12.
I'm asking for what kind of number, not examples of numbers. Catherine?
4.
So 4 is a number, one of the numbers, but what kind of number would I like to plug in for x? So that when I multiply it by 1/4, I get
a
whole number. What kind of numbers, when you multiply them by 1/4, give you a whole number? 2, will 2 give us a whole number?
No.
It'll give us a half. 2 times a fourth is a half. So what numbers, when we multiply them by 1/4, will give us a whole number? 4 over 1. Multiple?
3.
Yeah.
3. Multiple of what?
4.
1 over 4. 4.
Multiples of 4. Multiples of 4.
8.
8 is a multiple of 4.
Yeah.
Negative 8 is a multiple of 4.
4.
4 is a multiple of 4. 16 is a multiple of 4. Any multiple of 4, anything that can be divided by 4 is the kind of number that makes our calculation easier. 12.
24.
Yes, all of these numbers.
32.
There's another one. All those numbers make our calculations a little easier, make the y value a whole number as opposed to a fraction. Okay? Makes it easier to calculate, makes it easier to graph. We like that. Yeah?
So you can just basically put any multiple of 4 and then just graph it?
Well,
as long as you have a big enough
graph. As long as you have a big enough graph, as long as you take a second and figure out what the y value is when you plug that number in, right? You just plug in a multiple of 4 and then multiply by 1/4. And now you have a point, plot the point, and another point. Make sense?
Yeah.
Yep.
So, what's the blue ribbon first place value of x that I'm plugging?
Zero.
Zero. It's still getting easier than zero. After that, what makes the answer come out a whole number?
Four.
This four. What is this number called in this?
Denominator?
The denominator.
Very good.
The denominator. So say, well, multiple of the denominator. Multiple of the denominator. Okay, something to keep in mind as we go on to number 11. Y equals negative x over 3 plus 4. Okay, so let's set ourselves up the table. Here we go. Plug in a value for x.
0.
Like it, blue ribbon. 0. What do we get out as the y when we plug 0 in for x?
Root is 3. Oh, it's the y?
4. Y value, the whole thing, the whole answer is 4. Because what happens, we plug 0 in for x, what's 0 divided by 3?
0.
0. Is there a negative 0?
No.
No, there's just 0. So 0 plus 4?
Is it 4?
It's 4. 0 plus 4 is 4. All right, next, what would be a number that would be easy to plug in for x? Any value of x is allowed, it's legal, it works, it will give an answer, you will get a y value, but there are some that make our life a little
4?
Well, we plug in a 4 for x. Let's see. We can. We absolutely can. So that gives us negative 4 over 3 plus 4. Now, to combine these, what do I need to find to combine these two?
Common denominator.
Okay, so now we have to find a common denominator. That's going to be negative 4/3 plus 12/3. That's going to equal 8/3. Okay, so I get 4 goes in, 8/3 comes out. 8/3 is a number. It certainly could make my best attempt to graph where I think 8/3 is. But what would be nicer is if this number came out to be what kind of a number? A whole number. We'd like a whole number. What we really call an integer, right? A positive or a negative whole number. So can you make a prediction about a number that I can plug in for x where I would wind up getting a whole number, Jasper?
3.
Negative 3 over 3 plus 4. Now what's 3 over 3?
1.
1. So we have negative 1 plus 4 is?
3.
Nice. I like whole numbers. I like that. Whole numbers make our life a lot easier. What's another number that I can plug in?
6.
That's 6. Negative 6 divided by 3 plus 4. 6 divided by 3?
3.
How not? Well,
2.
2. How nice. Right, that comes out to be a whole number because it is divisible by 3 plus 4, negative 2 plus 4,
two.
Look, whole number in, whole number out. That is nice. That's convenient. It makes our life a little simpler. Okay, redo that x-axis.
What about x being negative 3?
Absolutely, negative 3. And now look what happens. Negative 3 over 3 plus 4. Now what's negative 3 over 3?
0.
Negative 3 over 3.
Negative 1.
Negative 1. Negative 3 divided by 3 is negative 1. And then we multiply by a negative. So it's a positive 3, right? It's a positive, or sorry, positive what? 1, not positive 3.
Plus 5.
Plus 4 is 5. So we've got a lot of points with the whole number as x, a whole number as y. Okay? It doesn't make them right, right? I mean, it doesn't make them more right than something with a fraction as the y value, but it certainly is easier. Especially when it comes to graphing it, it's a lot easier to graph it. So 0, 4, 3, 3. So there's 3. We did a 6. 6 gives us a 2 for y. And negative 3 went the other direction. I like when people volunteer to go into the negative x values. It shows no fear. So negative 3 gives us a y of 5, which isn't surprising. I mean, look at the points that I just plotted. It looks like if I go back, the next point would be up here. Okay. And all these points seem to be forming what a kind of shape?
Line.
A straight line. Not a curvy thing. It is possible to get curvy graphs, but this is not one of them. This is a straight line. Arrows on it to show that it goes on forever. How many points did I just plot?
4.
And then after that? Yes, an infinite number, because that graph, that line right there, is made of an infinite number of points. Kind of a Christmassy graph. All right, questions about that one? Starting to make a little more sense?
Yep.
You could have just randomly thrown x's into this function. Probably if you just threw them in randomly, got some fractions. That's fine. You just have to be pretty good at graphing fractions. Let's look at this one. 4 goes in, 8/3 comes out. 1, 2, 3, 4. 8/3 is almost 9/3, so it's almost 3. So it's 2 2/3. However you want to come about that answer. So 4, okay, there's 2. There's 2 right there. And it looks like a little bit higher than that is this point right here. Looks like it's at 4 and 2 2/3 for y. Okay, just a little bit higher than 2. You see what I'm saying there? It looks like this point right here is at 4, 2 2/3, which is just the same as 8/3. Okay, good. Questions? No questions? That's fine. Doing it today. Here we go. Number 15. I remember this one from last class is x equals 0.5. Now this is kind of weird. Because there's no y. The y is gone. It's just x equals. It's never looked like that before. Yeah?
Maybe it's negative 0.
Yeah.
Oh, the last class line. Negative 0.5. We've got to figure this out. How do we graph this thing? Let me just remind you of something. We have a point on this graph at 6, 2. Okay. We found that by plugging in. Or no, not. Yeah, so we have a point at 6, 2. We found it by plugging in 6, and then y came out to be 2. But another way of looking at it is if I plug in 6 and 2, let's see what happens. 2 for the y value. 6 for the x value. What's negative 6 divided, or what's 6 divided by 3?
2.
And it's negative, right?
Yeah.
What's negative 2 plus 4?
2.
Hopefully we're not too incredibly shocked by the fact that we just got 2. But what can you say about this equation? 2 equals 2. What's that?
True.
It's true. The equation, Jasper, yes. The equation is true. 2 does equal 2. If it said 2 equals 3, we'd have a problem, right? 2 equals 2. So the way we can look at it is if I take a point from the graph and I put the x and the y into the equation, then the equation should be true. The equation should be equal on both sides. That's why these points belong to this graph, because that's exactly what these points do. So we look at this graph. Now we just need like any point on this graph, when we plug the x in, we get a true equation. So what x would I have to plug in here for this equation to be true?
0.5?
You might not be able to see this negative here. I'd have to plug in negative 0.5 for x. Is there any other x value I can plug in? Can I plug in 2?
Nope.
If I plug in 2, let's see what happens. I plug in 2 for x, 2 equals what? Negative 0.5. Is that true? Not true. So could that x value work? That x value cannot work. Okay. So what x value can I plug in for x?
Negative
0.5. That is the only one that is available. Back here we had, because it's contradictory, I said just put any x you want in there, right? But that's when there was a y, now there's not a y, if it makes sense of that. So we can show me on the plane, that's what we call this, the xy axis. We can show me on the plane where x is equal to negative 0.5. Let me just put some tick marks here. Who can show me where x is equal to negative 0.5?
The flat x plane,
mm-hmm.
right there, and then before the first mark on the left side,
here,
in the middle.
Right there. Does everybody agree that x is equal to negative 0.5 right there?
Yes.
Okay. Is there anywhere else on this infinite plane where x is equal to negative 0.5? Any other point? Brandon?
On the right side.
Here?
Yeah. No, on the up and down.
Here?
Yeah.
Here.
Wait, there's like, no, on the right side. But.
Not here.
I'm
talking about any place where x is equal to negative 0.5.
On the up and down y-axis, the level part.
Here?
Yeah.
Is x equal to negative 0.5 there?
Yeah.
Tell me the coordinates of this point. It's got two parts, right?
Oh.
Like if I were to go and try to
negative
locate it by its coordinates.
Negative 0.5.
X comes first,
x,
right?
X.
Zero. Zero for x.
Zero.
And negative 0.5. So there is a negative 0.5, but what is negative 0.5 about this point? The y value is negative. So is x equal to negative 0.5 at that point?
No.
So then we should just back it up. Nope. Where else is x? What other point is x equal to negative 0.5, James?
Negative
0.5, comma 1. Negative 0.5, comma 1. Does this point have an x that is equal to negative 0.5?
Yeah.
What are the coordinates at this point? What are the coordinates at this point?
0.
Okay, first I go to x, right? I go to the left, how much?
Negative
0.5. Negative 0.5, comma 1. So is this true? Is x equal to negative 0.5 for this point?
Yeah.
It is. There's the x of negative 0.5. Where else is x equal to negative 0.5? In the lower part?
Yeah, the bottom
negative
of it.
Where?
So it's negative point five and then negative 1.
Okay, right there. Where else?
Couldn't it be like infinite?
Infinite in which direction?
Negative.
Up and down, yeah. What do we call that in terms of E?
Vertical.
Vertical.
How many points is that?
Three.
Infinite number of points. Every single point has something in common. What do all of these points have in common?
They're all equal. Make a line. Y'all make a line.
That's not what they have in common. There's something the same about all of them.
They equal negative 0.5.
The x of every point equals negative 0.5. The y doesn't matter, does it? There's nothing about y in this equation. Y doesn't need to be anything. X just needs to be negative 0.5. And is it? Yes. Well, that's interesting. What kind of slope does it have is a good question.
Like
just to... So the slope of this line is undefined. But that's gonna, we haven't really talked about slope. We'll talk about slope more later, okay? But if you're curious and you know something about slope, you've heard about slope, you're wondering about slope, slope of this is undefined. But we'll find out more why later, and not today. All right, let's clear our desks.
Hello?
No!
Sure. Bye.
So, we need some points, okay? So let's find the easiest point by plugging in what?
Zero.
Zero, right? Zero is zero. Zero times 2/3 is zero, plus one is?
Zero.
Oh, what?
Zero plus one. Zero plus one. Plug in three, yeah, we get 2/3 times 3/1 plus one. You get 2 times 3 is 6/3. Plus 1, what's 65 by 3?
2.
2 plus 1 is 3. So 0, 1.